Joe DeBlasi for the Varsity Sports Network here at St. Paul's. It was all Jamal Wade's again today. He goes 7 complete innings on the mound. He throws a 5-hitter. He only gives up 1 run. And now in 8 plus 7 is 15 innings of work against St. Joe on this mound this year. You have given them 1 run, and they're a very good team. To put icing on the cake, Kiefer hits a double in the first inning, the second guy up, and you smash about a 365-foot homer to right. Shows you had some power going down the right field line, but we knew that anyway. 2-run homer, which would have stood up, but you guys get 2 insurance runs in the fourth, one on a single by Connor Brown, and the other was on a walk with the bases loaded. Having said all that, I know you were sharp again, finishing with that fastball, and you relied on your curveball. Tell me about the pitch you hit, though, with an 0-2 count in the first inning to give your team a 2-0 lead.
Well, he threw a fastball. I was sitting curveball, actually, and then just trusting my hands, being confident is what it's all about. So I trusted my hands, took it the other way, and just went out. I didn't think it was going out right off the bat, but it carried a little bit, so.
It carried, and Peter Solomon is one of the top pitchers in the area, along with you and a lot of other guys that are in these playoffs. Now, on the mound, what did you rely on? What was working?
I actually threw the fastball a lot today. Usually I like to mix it up, throw some curveballs. I was throwing a little tight again today. I was breaking a little too much, throwing it in the dirt, having a little trouble finding it for a strike. So threw some fastballs, trusted the defense behind me. They were making plays all day.
First 2 innings, you struck out 5 guys out of the first 6 outs. What was that out pitch? What was that strikeout pitch at that point?
At that point in the beginning, I was throwing curveballs in the beginning. Set him up with fastball, come back with a curveball, and then try and throw a high fastball, try and get him a swing. They weren't swinging, so came with another curveball, and they went for it.
Try to keep him off balance.
Yep.
You ended up with 8 strikeouts on the day. You throw a 5-hitter, only give up 1 run. Now you guys, for those that watch the Varsity Sports Network, you will be playing the #1 seed, Spalding, at Spalding on Monday. St. Joe falls the loser's bracket. They'll play the loser, I believe, of tonight's Gilman-Calvert Hall game. And the winner of that game goes to Curley on Monday. So there's a little recap for anybody watching that interview. But congratulations to Jamal Wade again. Another outstanding performance on the mound and at the plate for St. Paul's today. Thanks for coming on.
Thank you.